वक्रतुंड महाकाय सूर्यकोटिसमप्रभ निर्विघ्नं कुरु मे देव सर्वकार्येषु सर्वदा। सरस्वती नमस्तुभ्यं वरदे कामरूपिणी विद्यारंभं करिष्यामि सिद्धिर्भवतु मे सदा। गुरवे सर्वलोकानां विषये भवरोगिणां निधये सर्वविद्यानां दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। सदाशिवसमारम्भां शङ्कराचार्यमध्यमाम् अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्ताम् वन्दे गुरुपरम्पराम्। श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानाम् आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शङ्करं लोकशङ्करं साक्षात्कृतं दयानन्दं परमार्थस्वरूपिणं तत्त्वज्ञानप्रशास्तारं प्रणतोऽस्मि परं पदम्। ॐ सहना भवतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। ॐ नमो भगवते वैवस्वताय मृत्यवे ब्रह्मविद्याचार्याय नचिकेतसे च। Mantra number 12. You can repeat that. Yesha sarveshu bhuteshu.
Yesha sarveshu bhuteshu. Wow. Wow. Gosh.
Kudo mana kudo nashate.
Kudo mana kudo nashate.
Is my voice clear?
Yes, Guruji.
Your voice is clear, but someone's nice voice is coming very, very disturbing. Some one of the noises, whatever.
Parvati ji, your side. I'll mute your mic. Esha sarveshu bhuteshu.
Esha sarveshu bhuteshu.
गूढोत्मान प्रकाशते।
गूढोत्मान प्रकाशते।
दृश्यते त्वग्रया बुद्ध्या।
दृश्यते त्वग्रया
सूक्ष्मया सूक्ष्मदर्शिभिः।
सूक्ष्मया सूक्ष्मदर्शिभिः।
Yes, in the simple meaning of this mantra. Sarveshu Bhuteshu, Brahmadi Stambha Paryanteshu, Shara जंतुषु अचर वस्तुषु सर्वेषु भूतेषु प्राणिषु स्थितः एषः आत्मा प्रत्यक्चैतन्यरूपः एषः आत्मा गूढः गूढः इस् अविद्यया आच्छादितः संवृतः इस् कवर्ड एज़ दो कवर्ड आच्छादितः सन् न प्रकाशते because it is covered therefore this atma sakashta saparagatihi that atma which is the purusha purusha purushah chaitanyam which is na prakashate iti that chaitanyam is which is ananda rupaha aham sarvasmat paraha aham it is gudaha therefore it is vyavahara yogyaha na bhavati in the presence of which every vyavahara all the transaction takes place into that vyavahara yogyaha na bhavati therefore this atma na prakashate it is not recognized avrutah san achannah san na prakashate that is gragya gragaka rupena avidya dashayam na avalokyate atma this purushah then katam vigneyah it is kaihi इट इज सूक्ष्म दर्शिभिः सूक्ष्मिया बुद्ध्या अग्रया सूक्ष्मिया बुद्ध्या सूक्ष्म दर्शिभिः एव दृश्यते प्रकाशते तैः एव अवलोक्यते दिस आत्मा बाय देम तीक्ष्ण बुद्धि बाय द पर्सन हु हैज तीक्ष्ण बुद्धि संस्कृत बुद्धि तैः एव एषः पुरुषः साक्षात् क्रियते इट इज साक्षात् क्रियते अवलोक्यते इट इज रिकग्नाइज्ड बाय देम ओनली दिस इज रिकग्नाइज्ड आत्मा इज रिकग्नाइज्ड सो दैटफॉर दृश्यते आत्मा न प्रकाशते किंतु दृश्यते बाय दिस बुद्धि बाय द बुद्धि दैट इज द बुद्धि व्हिच इज सूक्ष्म बुद्धि द बुद्धि विच इज इट हैज गॉट सर्टेन चित्त शुद्धि एंड चित्त निश्चल्यम दैटफॉर सूक्ष्म बुद्धिया एंड द पर्सन हु हैज दिस सूक्ष्म सूक्ष्मम आत्मतत्वं द्रष्टुं शीलम येषां ते तैः सूक्ष्म दर्शिभिः पंडितैः By the panditas, by the jnanis, they have this sukshma buddhi. Therefore, taiki drishyate katam guru upadishta maha vakya janyaya jnanena drishyate yeshakatma pratyak rupena. It is not different from oneself. Pratyak rupena, this atma is sakshat kriyate drishyate. This is the meaning of this. The mantra which we have been seeing in the last class also and before that also and the bhashyam we have read you can just read the bhashyam I think we have to read the contention of the purva pakshi we can read the bhashyam from the beginning and then start from the contention of the purva pakshi yesha purushah सर्वेषु ब्रह्मादिस्तंभ पर्यन्तेषु भूतेषु गूढः संवृतः दर्शन श्रवणादि कर्म
दर्शन श्रवणादि कर्मा
अविद्या माया छन्नः अतः एव आत्मा न प्रकाशते आत्मत्वेन कस्यचित् अहो अतिगम्भीरा दुरवगाह्या विचित्रा माया विचित्रा माया च इयम् यत् अयम् सर्वः जन्तुः परमार्थतः परमार्थसतत्वः अपि एवं बोध्यमानः अहम् परमात्मा इति न गृह्णाति अनात्मानं देहेन्द्रियादिसङ्घातमात्मनः दृश्यमानमपि घटादिवत् आत्मत्वेन मनुष्यपुत्रः इति नॉट न अहम् आत्मत्वेन देन अहम् मनुष्यपुत्रः इति अनुच्यमानः अपि गृह्णाति नूनं परस्य एव मायया मुमुक्ष्यमानः सर्वः लोकः ब्रह्मणीति परस्य एव मायया इम्पोर्टेण्ट् माया विच् इस् नाट् डिफरेण्ट् फ्रोम् दि पर दर् इस् ब्रह्म परस्यया मायया एव मुमुख्यमानः सर्वलोकः बम्ब्रमीति तथा च स्मरणम् नाहं प्रकाशः सर्वस्य योगमाया समावृतः इत्यादि The brief meaning of these lines, the Bhashyam, is this Maya, starting from Brahma up to the Stambha. Stambha is the grass. Sarveshu Bhuteshu, it is Guraha, it is hidden, it is covered. Covered by Avidya, Maya. In the presence of which all the darshanadi activities happen. And that Atma na prakashate, not recognized as oneself. Atma tvena kasichita na prakashate na drishyate iti. Therefore, this maya, it is atigambira, duravakagya, vichitra, iyam maya, sarvaha jantuhu, all the beings, paramartataha, paramartha satattvam api, even though it is the tattvam, the satyam of all the In reality, it is the satyam of all the beings api. And even if these beings are taught, bodhyamanaha api. Avam paramatma iti bodhyamanaha api. Even if it is taught, nagrunnati, it is not recognized. Whereas, anatma, degendriyari sangata anatma, this body, mind, sense complex, this karyakarana sangata, even though it is not taught that you are this, Anuchyamanaha api. I am the son of so and so. Nobody taught. But it is, even though it is not taught, but it is grinnati. This anatma is taken to be oneself, but not atma. Even though anatma has not been taught, But one takes oneself to be an Atma. Even when Atma is taught, then it is not Atmatvena, not taken to be oneself. Navrinnati iti Vashikara says. Therefore, it is this Maya, certainly this Maya, because of this Maya, well, Sarvalokaha Momugyamanaha, the entire Loka, which is Momugyamanaha, which is deeply, repeatedly, intensively deluded. Therefore, they move around. Bambramiti iti. Itacha Shutivakyam Nagam Prakasha Sarvasya Yokamaya Samavrataha Iti Gitayam Bhagavata Uttam Aham Na Prakashaka Aham Na Prakashaka Sarvasya Na Prakashaka I am not evident to all the people. Why? Because Yoga Maya Samavrataha, covered by Maya. Maya is Yoga, the combination of the three gunas, the Gunatmika Maya. Trayanam, Gunanam, Samaharaha, Yoga, that is called Yoga, the three gunas. Maya, Yoga refers to the Maya, which has these three gunas. Because of these three gunas, you see the entire Jagat as though came out from Brahma. Which covers the Brahma, this Pratyekatma. Therefore, Samyak Avrataha iti Vidayam Uttam. Now the Purva Pakshi raises an objection. From that we will read. Na viruddham idam uchyate. Objection. Virudham uchyate. It is contradictory. This shloka tells na prakashate. This Atma is na prakashate. Whereas in the next chapter, first valli, fourth mantra, matva diraha na shochati. Matva diraha na shochati iti. In the second chapter, the first valli itself, the Upanishad says. So Purupakshi is quoting from the same Upanishad. Matva diraha na shochati iti swatmanam jagaritantam shobau ena anupashyati mahantam vivumatmanam matva dhiro na shochati iti atmanam matva mahantam vibhum atmanam matva na shochati. Having known that atma, which is mahantam, which is great, and it is vibhum, it is all-pervading Atma, which is all-pervading, it is the Karanam. It is not different from the Karyam. Matva, having known, Dhiraha na shochati. Dhiraha viveki purusha na shochati. Iti, the mantra tells. But this mantra says, na prakashate. So the doubt is, you say Atma na prakashate. It is not recognized, not available for recognition, Atmatvena, as oneself. This mantra says. Whereas, the mantra which is going to come says, Dhiraha Viveki, having known this Atma, it doesn't grieve. One said you say, this Atma is not recognizable, not available for comprehension, it is unknowable, whereas the Atma. We also say, having known this Atma, Dhira Purushaha, Dhiraha Viveki, Na Shochati Iti. So therefore, it is contradictory. Viruddham idam, Virudha. It is Virudha Vakya. Rudani Vakyani. That is why Upanishad should not be studied by oneself. Such statements will be there which seems to be contradictory. Which seems to be contradictory. It is not, they are not contradictory. But to understand the spirit of the statement, to understand the Vakya of the Upanishad, one should have the overall picture, the Tatparyam of the Upanishad. Then only the Vakya can be interpreted. Without knowing the Tatparya, you cannot study the mantra of the Upanishad. You cannot study the mantra of the Upanishad individually. Individual mantra, the meaning of the mantra cannot be understood without knowing the total meaning. Without knowing the total, you cannot understand the individual mantra. Without the individual mantra, the total meaning cannot be understood. Therefore, it is, there is a anyonya ashraya. Meaning of the individual mantra depends on the meaning of the total Upanishad. And the meaning of the total Upanishad depends on the meaning of the individual mantra. So there is a anyonya ashraya. So therefore, it has to be taught. It is not to be read by oneself. That is why this is a teaching. This is a teaching, not preaching. This is a class. Because such statements are contradictory, therefore doubt may come. And Bhashyakara, through the mouth of Purva Pakshi, he presents the doubt and clarifies. Bhashyakara says, Naitadevam. Then repeat.
Naitadevam. Naitadevam.
Na etatu evam. Naitadevam. Na etatu evam. This is not so. Na etatu evam. Naitadevam is na etatu evam. This is not so. It means it is not contradictory. The statements are not contradictory. Etatu evam na. You say it is contradictory. It is not. It is not so. Then the next line. Asamskrita buddhehe.
Asamskrita buddhehe.
Avigneyatvat.
Avigneyatvat.
Na prakashate iti uttam.
Na prakashate iti uttam.
Asamskrita buddhehe. Asamskrita buddhi. Asamskrita buddhehe. Avigneyatvat na prakashate. It is na prakashate. Upanishad says, na prakashate, that is yuktam eva. It is yuktam eva. This atma, it is not available for the comprehension. It is yuktam eva, it is correct only. But we have to add one more word. For whom? For the person. For a person who has asamskrita buddhi. Who has asamskrita buddhi. Whose buddhi is not samskrita, whose buddhi is not the refined buddhi. The refined buddhi means the buddhi is not prepared for this knowledge. Not prepared, not able to, not doesn't have sufficient, doesn't have sufficient the penetrating thinking intellect to understand this sukshma vishaya. This is sukshma. Why it is sukshma? This being the very subject, therefore it is sukshma. It is like a torchlight with the help of its light seeing, trying to see itself. That's why it is sukshma. The torchlight doesn't need light to see itself. The presence of the light of the torch only, with other things are illumined. But now the torchlight wants to know its illumination, itself. Therefore, it is sukshma. The subject matter is the very subject. If it is an object, then further you don't need the Sanskrita Buddhi, that much Sanskrita Buddhi. Here the subject matter is the very subject itself. Therefore, Sukshma Buddhi is required. Therefore, it is Durvijnayaha. Dukkena Bodhum Vishayaha. Therefore, Avijnayaha. Avijnayatvat. Not having the status for, not having the status for, status of comprehension. Why it is Durvijnayaha, Avijnayaha? Because na drashtehe drashtaram pashyehe, na shrutehe shrotaram shrunuyaha, na matehe mantaram manvitaha, na vijnatehe vijnataram vijaniyaha. Bhagavad Upanishad says, Atma, katam Atma asti, if he asks, how this Atma is? Drashtehe drashtaram na pashyehe. This Atma, in the presence of which all the Indriyas, everything function as they are supposed to. Sarva Indriyani Samvyapya, Indriyanam api Indriya Bhutaha. It is the Indriya of the Indriyas. It is the Manas of the Manas, mind. It is the eye of the eye. It is the ear of the ear. Therefore, Indriyaihi vijnatum na shakyate. Netraihi rupani drashtum shakyante. Netraihi rupani drashtum shakyante. Kintu netra drashtaram atmanam na shakyate. Na shakyante. Netra drashtaram na shakyate. Drashtum na shakyate. Netraihi. With the eye you can see the rupas. Eyes are meant for seeing the forms, the shape. With the eyes, you can see the forms of the objects. What about drashtaram, the seer? Can you see the seer with the eyes? Netrahi drashtam na shakyate. Not possible. Tadvateva shrotranam api. Shrotranam, this atmabhutam, shrotranam atmabhutam, atmanam, oneself, shrotraihi, shrotraihi shrotum na shakyate. Shrotraihi shrotum na shakyate. With the eye, you cannot listen to the shrota, with the ears. Shrotra is ears. Shrotraihi, with the ears, shrotum na shakyate. Shrotraihi, shrotra, shrotaram, shrotraihi, Shrotum na shakyate. Tadvateva manasa khapi. Manasa mantum na shakyate atma. Therefore it is durvijnayaha. Avijnayatvat. Na prakashate. The meaning is this. It is not recognizable. Why? It is not recognizable as you recognize, as you comprehend other things. Therefore it is durvijnayaha. Avijnayaha. Therefore, you need Sanskrita Buddhi. If Sanskrita Buddhi is not there, then it is not Vijnaya Vishaya. Therefore, Vashyakara says, Asanskrita Buddhehe Avijnayatvat Na Prakashate Iti Yuktam Yeva. It is proper to say, by the Asanskrita Buddhi, it is not comprehensible. Whereas, with the Sanskrita Buddhi, it is possible. Vashyakara says that. Drishyate tu.
Drishyate tu.
Samskritaya agraya.
Samskritaya agraya.
Agram iva agrayaya taya.
Agram iva agrayaya taya.
Eka grataya upetaya.
Eka grataya upetaya.
Ityetat.
Ityetat.
So Sanskritaya Buddhya Drishyate. By the Sanskrita Buddhi, it is Drishyate. It is comprehensible, recognizable. Drishyate, Prakashate, Nyatum Shakyate. As a Vishaya. Here we have to know. The Sanskrita Buddhi, With the buddhi, it is available for cognition, for understanding. It says, by the buddhi, it is available for cognition, recognition, comprehension. Now, we have to understand here. If it is available for the Samskrita buddhi, it means whether it is Samskrita buddhi or Asamskrita buddhi. When something is available for your cognition, for your recognition, it means it must be the object of your comprehension. You see an object, an apple. You recognize it as an apple. So apple vritti takes place in the mind, in the buddhi, in the mind, and buddhi recognizes. I use the word buddhi because Upanishad here says buddhi, therefore buddhi. Bhashyakara says buddhi, so I use the word buddhi for mind. So buddhi recognizes it as an apple. So apple vritti takes place in the buddhi. Apple is an object, and the vritti is apple. That is an object. So vritti is also an object. Now, what about this atma vritti? If atma also is recognizable as a vritti, then atma also is an object. No, it is not so. Not like that. The very vritti is because of atma. So, in the presence of vritti, atma is. In the absence of vritti also, atma is. It is a akandakara vritti. The vritti which doesn't have division. Whereas other vritti, object vrittis, they have division. Now I see an apple, apple vritti. Then I see a tree, tree vritti. Then I see a mountain, mountain vritti. Then I see a flower, flower vritti. I see a leaf, leaf vritti. All these are different vrittis. One come after the other. One frame goes, another frame comes. One frame goes, another frame comes. And it looks as though it is a series of frames. In each frame, Atma is there. When the apple thought came, Atma is. When the tree thought came, Atma is. And other thoughts, subsequent thoughts came, Atma is. The first thought is apple. Apple vritti, atma is. Second thought, tree, apple is. These thoughts are frames, individual frames, not continuous. One comes and goes, the next one comes. And in between the two vritti, what is there? In between the two vritti, there is no vritti. Vrittiless vritti, if at all we can call. That is the akandakara vritti. In between the two vritti, there is no thought. And that gap, that space where there is no thought, who is there? Is it available for objectification? It is not objectified. That is the turiyam, it is the atma, it is the akandakara vritti. This is what we do in the meditation. In meditation, we take a very simple mantra. Om Ishaya Namaha. Don't take any long mantra, simple mantra. Ishaya Namaha. Om also you can drop. Ishaya Namaha. Only two words. Ishaya Namaha. Ishaya Namaha. Ishaya Namaha. Ishaya Namaha. Ishaya Namaha. First Ishaya Namaha thought came. Second Ishaya Namaha. third Ishaya Namaha. All these are, you deliberately create vritti. Ishaya Namaha. And next Ishaya Namaha. You don't give long space, a space, sufficient space for the next chant. In the presence of first chant, Atma is, you are. Atma means you. Then the next chant came, you are. So you keep doing it, and in between the two chants, who is that? There is no chant, but who is there in the between the two chant? The first, the presence of first chant, you are there. Second chant, you are there. In between the two chant, there are no chants, but there are no chants, there are no vritti, therefore no chanting, therefore no vritti. But continue to be, Atma continue to be. Is it available for objectification? In one way you can say it is available as a vrittiless vritti, as an objectification. That is an expression you can say. But it doesn't have vritti like the apple tree or even the chant. Not that type of vritti. That is why it is called akandakara vritti. It is a continuous. It is not, it doesn't have fragments like the vrittis of apple tree, flower. It is not fragmented vritti. It is one continuous vritti, akandakara vritti. That is you, the Atma, ever shining, self illumining, self evident. That Atma is that. That in the space, it is recognized. In the meditation, we do it. And as a preparation for meditation, we give it a mathematical calculation. The mind has to be prepared. The mind has to be very sukshma. It has to be prepared. Sukshma means it has to be alert. Therefore, first we give some mathematical calculation. 4 plus 4, 8. 8 plus 8, 16. 16 plus 16, 32. 32 plus 32, 64. 64 plus 70, 134. 134 plus 236, you have to count. Now your focus is only on the addition, the calculation. The mind is, doesn't go anywhere else. You don't think about your family. You don't think about other things. No worries, no concern. Only focused on this calculation. So the mind is focused. Now you put the chant. Ishaya Namaha. Ishaya Namaha. Ishaya Namaha. And watch the gap. This is a meditation we do. So, therefore, even in this meditation, you see how the mind is first prepared, and the space between the two thoughts is taken as the object of meditation. That is what is talked about. In that way, we can take the Atma as the vrittiless vritti, akandara kritti, akandakara vritti. That is drishyate, not as an object, not as an any other object. That akandakara vritti drishyate katam samskritaya buddhya. That is why ekagrata, that is why concentration. Ekagrata is important. Ekagrata is important. Ekagrata means the buddhi is refined. The buddhi is prepared. So, samskrita buddhya, samskritaya agraya. Agraya is agrim. Here, agram is the word, but if agram is the word, then this must be, agraya must be, but Upanishad use agraya. Agraya, it is chandasam. So it's a Vedic form. Agram. Agram means that which is in front. So agraya ekagrataya. Agram. Only one object is there. Ekam eva agram. Yasya saha. And status of having that. Ekagrataya buddhya. That is a sukshma buddhi. But taya drishyate, it is recognized. The Vashyakara says, this is the Samskrita Buddhi. For Samskrita Buddhi, Atma is cognizable, available for recognition. Not as an object. not as an object available for sense perception, not like that. It is available as akandakara vritti. Okay, then the next line. For whom? Kaihi.
Kaihi.
Sukshma darshibihi.
Sukshma darshibihi.
Indriyebhyah parahirtah.
Indriyebhyah parahirtah.
Ityadi prakarena.
Ityadi prakarena.
Sukshmata paramparya darshanena. Param sukshmam drashtum shilam esham te.
Param sukshmam drashtum shilam esham te.
Sukshma darshinaha.
Sukshma darshinaha.
Taihi sukshma darshibihi.
Taihi sukshma darshibihi.
Panditaihi.
Panditaihi.
Ityetat.
Ityetat.
So, sukshmaya sukshma vastu nirupana paraya. That part I think I didn't get. Anyway. So, sukshmaya sukshma vastu nirupana paraya. With the commitment. Paraya is with the commitment. With the commitment to sukshma vastu nirupana. In ascertaining the sukshma vastu. Why Sukshma Buddhi is required? Sukshmaya with the Sukshma Buddhi. That is Sukshma Buddhi. Sukshmaya, it is there in the mantra, which is equal to Sukshma Vastu Nirupana Paraya. The mind which is committed to ascertain the Sukshma Vastu, Sukshma Vishaya. Therefore, Sukshmaya Buddhya. Atma is Sukshma, being the subject. Therefore, it is Sukshma. It is doesn't have any size. Sukshma means, you should not think, every word has got some problem. Sukshma, when we say, we think it is smaller in size. We always think in terms of size, Sukshma. Mahan, when we say, we think it is a big. With regard to Atma, whether it is neither Sukshma nor Mahan, at the same time it is both. Anoraniya, Nagato Magiya. So, what is Sukshmaya? That is Sukshma Vastu Nirupana Paraya. The Buddhi must have the commitment to understand, to ascertain the Sukshma Vastu. Atma being Sukshma, therefore, that commitment should be there. Why? Because Atma is Avyaktam. It is Avyaktam. It is Achintyaha. It is not available for cognition. Therefore, Sukshmaya, Buddhya, Iti. Kaihi, by whom? Sukshma darshibhi, by the person who can see through things. Sukshma darshibhi. Sukshmam drashtam shilam yeshamte. The people who have this habit of seeing. Shilam is their conduct, the behavior, the habit of seeing the sukshma vastu. It means the mind is prepared. They have got that antakharana, the mind, which can see through things. A preparation is required. How do you get the preparation? By karma yoga and by upasana. By karma yoga chitta shuddhi, by upasana ekagrata. That is why in the shastram, the Upanishad itself, you will find a lot of upasana. Japa, dhyana, all these are important. Karma yoga is important. Reaching out action is important. Panchamaga yajna is important. All this gives Chitta Shuddhi, and Upasanaya Chitta Naishchalyam. Then only Buddhi becomes Sukshma. That is a Vedic scheme of life. That is why I suggest to do karma in the beginning, combined with Upasana, not for gaining any Sukham, either in this world or other world. If you are a committed student, then Iha Amutra Sarga Bhogeshu Ichara Gityam. That Viraga is required. Vairagya. At the same time, we do this upasana to gain the chitta shuddhi. So, taihi purushaihi sukshma darshibhihi prakarena, evam prakarena, in this manner. What manner? Indriya vyapara hirtaha iti paramparya darshanena, in this, the gradation, paramparya, this in this darshanam. Darshanam means that which has been shown. Seeing the paramparya, seeing the gradation of the subtlety, param sukshmam drashtum shilam eshante, the one who has the habit of seeing this subtle thing, has the capability of seeing through things. Ityadi prakarena taihi, by that person, sukshma darshibhihi, panditaihi, who are they? They are pandita. Pandita means, panda means jnanam. Panda, yasya, asya asti, pandita, taihi. The person who has, panda means jnani. They have this buddhi. Jnani means, need not be brahmajnani. Here this means, jnanam, the person has the capability to understand, panditaihi. And jnani also we can take, because jnani has this jnanam, therefore, jnani also we can take. Jnani is one who has reached, and others are the mumukshus. They are in the process. So, panditaihi sukshma darshibhihi drishyate iti etat. Therefore, this atma is available for comprehension, available for understanding. The person has samskrita buddhi. Samskrita buddhi is required. Otherwise, na drishyate na prakashate iti. Then, the next mantra. Tat Pratipatti Upayam Aha
Upayam Aha
Tat Pratipatti Upayam Aha. Upaya is the means. The means for Pratipatti, for gaining Tat Pratipatti. What that Pratipatti? Atmanaha Pratipatti. Pratipatti means knowledge. Upayam, the means. The means for gaining the Atmajnanam is told. Where? The next mantra. Please, when you unmute your mic, make sure that there is no background noise. Okay. If background noise is there, please mute. Next mantra. Vasantiji, you can mute your mic. Yachedvang manasi prajnyaha.
Yachedvang manasi prajnyaha.
Tadyachedjnanamatmani.
Tadyachedjnanamatmani.
Jnanamatmani magati niyachet. Tadyachedchantaatmani. Everybody, chanta. That chattavidhi, what we saw in the Sanskritam class, it happens. Anyway, I'll tell the meaning of, simple meaning of this mantra. Yet, not yet. Yachet is one. Yachet is a kriyapadam. Yachet, vak, manasi. Here it is vak plus manasi become vang manasi. Vak plus manasi become vang manasi. Yaraha anunasike, anunasikova. Therefore, when you speak, these are individual padam. Okay, vang manasi is not a samasa. It is vak and manasi, individual padam. Vak means vacham. Yachet, vak, manasi, manasi is there. There is no manasi is a manasa, manasi. It is not the dual also. Manasi, the dirga is used by the Upanishad. It is chandasam. It is manasi only. Short e only. Manasi. We will see Bhashyakara himself will say. So, yachet, kriyapadam, yachet. Linglakara, echet, vak, manasi, prajnyaha, tad yachet jnana, tad yachet jnana, tad yachet jnane, not jnana, jnane, echaha yavayavaha yakarasya lopaha bhavati, jnane, atmani, then jnanam atmani magati niyachet. Yachet, niyachet. It's a kriyapadam. Niyachet. Tat yachet. Again. Shanta Atmani. Shante. Again here. Shante. Shante Atmani yachet. Shante Atmani. Shante Atmani iti. Now we have to understand the meaning of the mantra. Individual padam we have seen. The meaning is yachet is the kriya padam. Yachet is the kriya padam. That is from the dhatu. Two dhatus will take the form yachati. Da dhatu also will take yachati. And yam dhatu also will take yachati. Yachati, yachataha, yachanti. That is the sense of giving. Yam means to restrain. Yama, niyama. That yam also will take the form yachati. So here the ling form is yachet, resolve, should resolve. Ling form, should resolve. What resolve? Vak manasi yachet. Vak manasi yachet. Kaha prajnyaha. Prajnyaha is equal to viveki, dhiraha, purushaha. Here prajnyaha is not the vyashti sulasha. Prajna is not this abhimana, the sharira abhimana, chaitanyam, sula, stukshma, karana, karana sharira, abhimani, atma, prajna, that is not here. Prajna means here, purushaha. Prakarshena, jnanamasti. Prajna is the one who has the knowledge. Prajna is diraha purushaha, viveki. That's called prajna. Prajnyaha yachet. Let the prajna resolve. Should resolve. What? Vak into the mind. Vak manasi yachet. So manasi saptami vibhakti. It is not manasi dvitiya prathama vibhakti dvivachanam or dvitiya vibhakti dvivachanam. It is not. It is saptami manasi. So let the prajna resolve the vak into the mind. Let the person resolve the vak, the speech. Vak means speech into the mind. I'm just giving the simple meaning of the mantra. You will see the mantra in detail. Then tataha manaha jnane atmani yachet. So first, he resolves the speech into the mind. Then, the mind should be resolved into Atmani. Mind should be resolved into Atmani. Here, Atmani is not Sachidananda Atmani. Atmani means Buddhi, intellect. The word Atma is used in many meanings in the Upanishads. Atma can mean Sachit Ananda Atma, that is Atma, consciousness, Chaitanyam. One meaning. Atma can be used in the sense of the shariram also, body or mind, buddhi. That also Atma is used. And Atma can mean the reflexive pronoun also. Atmanaha, oneself. Atmatvena vijaniyat. We saw in the previous mantra. Atmatvena. Reflexive pronoun. That is also Atma. So, the meaning of the word Atma depends on the context. So here, vak is resolved into the mind. Should resolve. The prajnaha should resolve the vak into the mind. And the mind should be resolved into the intellect, buddhi. So tataha, tat means refers to manaha. Tat manaha, tat refers to this mind, which is dvitiya bhakti ekavachanam. Tat Atmani niyachet. Tat jnane atmani niyachet. Jnane atmani is it. So jnane atmani, therefore jnane atmani is intellect. He should resolve tat, that is mind, into the intellect. Then jnanam magati atmani niyachet. That jnanam that jnanam mahati. Jnanam is the mind. He should resolve the intellect into the mahati atmani. Previously was jnane atmani, here mahati atmani. The previous one, jnane atmani, refers to individual buddhi. Magati Atmani refers to the Samashti Buddhi, which is Hiranyagarbha. So, he should niyachet, resolve Jnanam Magati. Magati Atmani. He should resolve the Buddhi into the Magati Atmani, that is Hiranyagarbha Magat, niyachet. Then, Tat. Echet Shanta Atmani. Then the Magat, Tat refers to that Samashti Buddhi, Hiranyagarbha. Tat Magat Shante Atmani Niyachet. He should resolve that into the Shanta Atma. Shante Atmani Niyachet. This is the meaning of this mantra. But what does it say? What do we understand this by this mantra? Mantra talks about the resolution of one thing into the other thing. One thing into the other thing. That is from vak to manas, manas to individual buddhi, individual buddhi to the samashti buddhi into atma. So from karya we arrive at the karanam. From karya we arrive at the karanam. So this shloka is a, it tells the means of gaining this Atma Jnanam. This shloka tells the means for gaining this knowledge, because Tat Prati Upayamaha, Vashakara said, Tat Prati Patti, Atmanaha Prati Patti Upayam, for gaining this knowledge of Atma. Upayam, the means is shown, the means is given. So, is a means for whom? For Sukshma Darshibihi, the one who has a Sukshma Buddhi. Now, Buddhi is Sukshma, therefore he can do the resolution. The resolution is cognitive resolution. The resolution is cognitive resolution. And understanding what Atma is. By resolution, you understand the Atma. By cognitive resolution, that is Upaya, that is a means for gaining this knowledge. Which the mantra says, the mantra gives the means, that is Nididhyasana. It tells the means of gaining, the method of gaining this knowledge by Nididhyasana. So it tells how to do the Nididhyasana. How to do the Nididhyasana. Three things are there: Shravanam, Mananam, Nididhyasanam. Shravanam, Mananam, Nididhyasanam. Shravanam, that is by the Pramana operation. The Prameya Jnana is by Pramana operation. So, Shravanam is the main thing. By Shravanena Jnanam Bhavati. By exposing oneself to the means of the knowledge, Jnana must happen. There is no question about it. There is no question about it. In case the knowledge doesn't happen, it means one has not yet prepared to gain the jnanam. Therefore, one has to do mananam nididhyasanam. Because some doubts are there, some doubts and habitual errors are there. Therefore, manana and nididhyasanam are important. And this has been talked about before itself. In the previous chapter also, this has been talked about this Atma. This Atma is Gudam, therefore it has to be known by the Jnana Yoga. Iti Yamadharma Raja himself had told this. If you see the first chapter, second section, 12th mantra, there he said, Tandur Darsham Gudam Anuprabhishtam Vagitam Gagvareshtam Puranam Adhyatma Yoga Digamena Devam Matva Diraha Arshashoko Jagati. Iti. That use the word Adhyatma Yoga. and we translated Adhyatma Yoga as Jnana Yoga. Adhyatma Yoga is Jnana Yoga. That is Vishayebhyah Pratisamhritya Chetasaha Pratisamhritya Atmani Samadhanam. That is called Adhyatma Yoga. That is what the Bhashyakara said in that mantra. Withdrawing the mind from the Vishayas and placing the mind in the Atma, that is called, that Samadhanam is called Adhyatma Yoga. That is called Jnana Yoga. That is what this mantra also says. That is Nididhyasanam. The method of gaining Atmajnan through Nididhyasanam. Atmajnanam is gained by Shravanam itself. But still, there are doubts and there are some habitual errors. Therefore, Nididhyasanam is recommended. Amadharma Raja has talked about Atma. The Shravanam has happened. Now he is talking about Nididhyasanam. So for Nididhyasanam, this mantra gives the upaya for the Atmajnanam through Nididhyasanam. So therefore, whatever has been heard, now it is assimilated, it is chewed, so that the errors goes away when we dwell on the teaching, when we dwell on the teaching of the Upanishad. So to recollect, it's a recollection. Nididhyasanam is recollection. Nididhyasanam is recollection of what has been heard. We have been hearing. Atma is anitya, it is karya. Anatma, not atma. Anatma is karya. And atma is the cause. So without atma, anatma is not. Anatma is mitya. Atma is satya. And karya karana prakriya. All these things have been heard. Now it is recollected. What has been heard is recollected. And now resolving anatma into atma. Resolving the anatma, because anatma doesn't have independent existence. Anatma has to be resolved in atma. Anatma has to be resolved, cognitively resolved in the atma, satya atma. So that happens out of understanding, and that understanding is talked about here. That understanding is talked about here. It is called Pravilapanam. It is called Pravilapanam, dissolution. Pravilapanam is dissolution, resolution. So here the method of Nididhyasanam talked about is Pravilapana Prakriya, Laya Prakriya. The Prakriya of contemplation, the Nididhyasanam talked about in this mantra is Pravilapana Prakriya or Laya Prakriya. That is the method of, it's an easy method of contemplation by which we arrive at Atma. How? By the dissolution of Anatma. We are resolving Anatma and arriving at Atma. So it is a resolution. Therefore, Pravilapana, Laya. Laya Prakriya, the method. So this is a Nididhyasana Prakriya. This is a Nididhyasana Prakriya, and specific name is Pravilapana Prakriya, Laya Prakriya. That is, Karya, from Karya you arrive at the Karanam. Karya doesn't have separate existence. So therefore, you inquire into the Karya and arrive at the Karanam. And that Karanam also is a Karya of some other Karanam. You inquire into it. And finally, arriving at the ultimate Karanam, which doesn't have any other Karanam. So in that way, we resolve everything into Brahma. And that Brahma happens to be myself. Like the Panchakosha Viveka we saw, starting from Annamaya Kosha and slowly arriving at cognitively at Pranamaya, Manomaya, Iti, then you arrive at Anandamaya, discarding all the other koshas are nothing but the Namarupa, and that you are the Satyavastu, everything is Mithya. That is the Pravilapana Prakriya, Laya Prakriya. So it's a Nididhyasana. It's a Nididhyasana. This mantra is for Nididhyasana. This mantra is it tells you how to do Nididhyasana. This mantra tells how to do Nididhyasana. So therefore, starting from Vak, ending with the Atma. So should resolution. Now we can read the Vashyam. And let me be one or two lines, then we can start today. Yachet. Niyachet.
Niyachet.
Yachet is equal to Niyachet. Nirundhyat. Resolve. It's a meaning Ling Lakara. Yachet, Niyachet. Upasamharet.
Upasamharet.
Upasamhara, resolution. So Bhashyakara gives another word, Upasamharet iti Rajnyaha.
Rajnyaha.
Viveki.
Viveki.
So Prajna should do the Upasamhara, should resolve. Yachet is equal to Niyachet. Niyachet is equal to Upasamharet. So should resolve, so should withdraw. Resolve means withdrawing. Withdrawing, Prajna is Viveki, the Dhira Purushaha, the wise man, should resolve. What? Vagvacham.
Vagvacham.
Vagvacham. That is, Vak is there, which is equal to Vacham. Which is equal to Vacham. Bhashyakara says, Vak is there in the Vak is done in the mantra, so Vak Vacham. So resolve the Vak, the speech organ, Vak into the mind. Vak is equal to Vacham. Okay, the Vak which occurs in the mantra, Vak which occurs in the mantra, it is not only for Vak. Should only the speech be resolved? No, it stands for all the other Indriya. Vak is Karmendriya, one of the Karmendriya. Five Karmendriyas, five Jnanendriyas are there. So 10 Indriyas are there. So Vak stands for all the Indriyas, not only speech. That Bhashyakara says. Vag Atra.
Vag Atra.
Upalakshan Artha.
Upalakshan Artha.
Sarvesham Indriyanam.
Sarvesham Indriyanam.
So Vak is only an Upalakshana. It is only represents. One represents the Indriya. We don't have to mention all the Indriya. One is enough. Representing one, the others are understood. That is called Upalakshana. So, Vak Atra Upalakshanartha. Upalakshanartha. Vak Atra Upalakshanartha. It is not Nartha. Vak is Srilinga. Vak is Srilinga. Therefore, Upalakshanartha Vak. Sarvesham Indriyanam Upalakshanartha Vak. So it is Strilinga, therefore Akaranta only. So Vak is only Upalakshana, stands for all the other Indriyas also. So all the Indriyas, let the Viveki withdraw into Manasi. Putra, the next question Devapada will ask. Kva Manasi. We will see that. We will see that in the next class. So we stop here. Om Purnamadah Purnamidham Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadhaya Purnameva Vishishyate Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi Harihi Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha
Harihi
Om
Dhanyavadah
Dhanyavadah.